Hi everybody and welcome back to Relax My Dog. Now today's video I'm going to be talking about how you can train your dog to sleep in their own bed. Now this is not a very good example right now because Milo is currently on my bed and he would never sleep here over the evening. He has his bed downstairs. I'm just going to be talking to you guys about how you can make sure your dog sleeps in their own bed. This can be very, very difficult because a lot of dogs can be stubborn when it comes to their own bed for a number of different reasons, which I'll get into during this video. But yeah, if you have any tips and tricks that you guys have learned as well over the years, please do drop them down below in the comments so that other people can give it a little bit of a reading and might help with their training as well. But let's just get started. So the first thing to take into account is the most important thing when training any dog to do any trick is repetition. Obviously you need to make sure that you're not just doing it the once, you're doing it continuously, you're not having a day off from it, because as soon as you have a day off, it almost takes them back to day one. So make sure you're being as repetitive as you possibly can when it comes to this training. The other aspect of training a dog to stay in their own bed is also comfort as well. Some dogs are extremely stubborn when it comes to the type of bed. You need to almost kind of look at how your dog sleeps on, like, normally, and then that will help you pick the dog bed. For example, if your dog sleeps in almost like a ball, getting a dog bed that sort of has a surround shape, that might be perfect for them because they can plonk on. Whereas a dog like Milo, who he doesn't really have a sleeping position, he just sleeps however he wants, but a lot of the time he'll just be slept like that, so just long ways, or when he's like on his side. So we got him a bed that was just a really big rectangle that was just cushioned, so that if he wanted to be half off the bed, half on the bed, he has that option. But yeah, you might need to do a few shopping trips to get the perfect bed for your dog. Similar with cats as well. Cats can be extremely stubborn when it comes to their bed, so make sure you're doing as much research as you possibly can into your dog's sleeping position and what doggy bed you need to get them as well. So once you've found the perfect dog bed, you also need to find the perfect position as well. It sounds really, really silly, but a lot of dogs might be scared of certain areas of the house, whether there's shelves on top of them or things close by that are big that they're scared of. So choosing an area of their dog bed is also really, really crucial as well. So there is a fine balance between finding the correct dog bed for your dog's needs and putting it in the correct spot to ease any fears or separation anxieties he may have. It may take a few weeks to train your dog to sleep in its own bed, but if it does, it's probably because you need to find a different spot for their bed. Many dog owners don't want their dog bed with them, but don't mind a dog bed in their bedroom. If your dog's bed is already in your bedroom, consider placing it closer to your bed so that your dog can look up and see you at night and hear you breathing, and that will just allow them to feel safe knowing you or at least another family member is nearby. But that is it for this week's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment down below, and also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and you would like to. And being a very tired man, Milo, we'll see you next week for next week's video. Bye.